We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
It's one small step for man.
One of humanity's greatest achievements.
One giant leap for mankind.
And one of humanity's greatest scientific tools.
The world's most brilliant astronomers do miracles with this observatory.
Hubble is profoundly significant, I think, for humanity.
You might be surprised to learn that the Hubble Space Telescope and landing on the moon in 2024 have a lot to do with each other. In fact, when you think of Hubble, usually those gorgeous pictures first come to mind. But after Jim Garvin's 2005 research using Hubble, what have we learned about prospecting the moon for locations to establish a human presence for the 2024 Artemis mission?
So Hubble's one little piece of that masterpiece of what we've been working on for 50 years so that people can use the moon as a special place, as Mother Nature's great control experiment next door.
Space telescope is, in a way, a little like Galileo's first telescope. Wherever Galileo pointed his telescope, he made major new discoveries. Look at the moon, you find mountains and craters. Look at Saturn, you find rings. Look at the Milky Way, you find it is littered and composed of stars. Every one of these discoveries, things that people had not known before. I think it's going to be very similar with the space telescope.
340 miles above the Earth's surface, Hubble orbits over the distorting effects of the atmosphere, enabling us to look deeper into space than any ground-based telescope. Hubble was specially designed to be upgraded while in space. Through 5 servicing missions over the years, astronauts have repaired, restored, and updated Hubble to make it better than ever. The Hubble Space Telescope has taught us a lot about our place in the universe. But back in 2005, then-NASA chief scientist Jim Garvin decided to focus Hubble's powerful instruments on something a little closer to home.
What if we used Hubble to do what it's best at? Be a precision photometer in wavelengths where it's very convenient, the lunar soils light up like firecrackers if they're rich in certain minerals. And we know from Apollo samples that some of the lunar soils and rocks are literally ore bodies. And so the idea of using Hubble with this exquisite ultraviolet imaging capability with the ACS instrument at that point, and then maybe later with others, to target the moon came alive.
Imagine, you're 240,000 miles away from Earth. Yeah, you'll be getting packages from home every once in a while, but you're gonna need to be self-sufficient too. And that's where Hubble comes in.
We realize that some of the moon rocks might be resources. And if they found them on Earth, we'd be mining them. So using the eyes of Hubble, where it has exquisite precision and resolution in ways that go beyond our eyes, beyond normal spacecraft we fly to orbit planets, was an opportunity to use an astronomical asset, a historical one, a cathedral to the stars, to observe the moon in a way where we could test, prospect for these resources in 3 places. And we were spectacular beyond success with the capability of Hubble to see things we couldn't see at finer scales. Hubble became a resource prospector to light the way for following missions, Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, to fill in the gaps, to paint the picture of the moon that we're going to go back to. We were attempting to be catalysts, pathfinders, for how we might use the moon in ways that are more creative than many had ever thought they could be used. What if we could live off the moon's resources in ways that enable us not to have to bring everything with us? And we'll use the moon as the springboard and the confidence to go on to Mars.
But establishing ourselves on the moon is just the first part of NASA's goal. There are some bigger plans in store for the future, and you can be sure that Hubble is a part of that next journey as well.
I'm very excited about the Artemis mission, but even beyond that, the whole idea is to go to Mars. So this whole process is, you know, about making sure we can get back to the moon safely and extending that to be able to journey to other planets like Mars in the future. And Hubble gets to study these objects in the solar system, including Mars. It studied weather on Mars regularly, and being able to monitor at great levels of detail these storms helps us better understand the surface of Mars and where it's safe to land, for example, and, you know, for humans to visit. And so Hubble's really been able to help, you know, be a part of this journey as humans get to go from the moon to Mars in that sense.
It's about newness. It's about challenge. It's about going out there in the forefront of technology and breaking through. And Hubble represents that to the greatest degree that I can think of, because it allows us to do it in a big way and in a small way. It allows us to do it in detectors, it allows us to do it in computer technology, in optical fabrication and optical polishing. But it also gives us this big picture. It also gives us this great challenge of making things better.
People everywhere look up at the same sky and say, you know, we're all part of something together. We're all citizens of planet Earth, and we're all part of this magnificent universe. And having some kind of constructive presence around the moon, I think it will be very exciting for people around the globe. So we are excited about that. And we're excited about the way science missions and satellites and probes and telescopes can complement human spaceflight to give us a full suite of information, whether it's trying to understand how humans can survive off planet Earth, or whether it's just basic curiosity about how did the Earth and the Moon form, and how does that compare to planets outside of our solar system. All of these information gathering missions are very helpful to our understanding of who we are as human beings and to our quest for exploring space.
One object that's in our destiny is the Moon. We've been there 6 times, 50 years ahead of our time with Project Apollo. We're ready to go back, women and men, for the long haul. And that prime directive will put people on the moon again in the year 2024. Hubble has been one of those pieces of the mosaic of information that help us understand what the moon offers, what we could use the moon for as we're there. So now we could see our universe, our solar system in a new light, and now we're ready to capitalize on that. And that's what Artemis, what Hubble, what the future of space exploration is about. Let's capitalize on what we learned. We're out of the dark ages. We're coming into the new light. Let's go.